For those of you who don't know me, I'm Nicholas Claxton, the COO of Elaph Media Publications. At the end of June, Elaph, the independent online Arabic newspaper, signed an exclusive agreement with the FT to produce the FT's luxury magazine, How to Spend It in Arabic. Not just translated content for the Arab world, but also original content produced by Elaph as well, to provide our readers with special stories from across the Middle East, North Africa, and elsewhere, both digitally and in print each month. On behalf of Othman Al-Amer, the founder and chairman of Elaph, and everyone at Elaph Media Publications, I'd like to say how excited we all are by this new venture with the FT and how great it is to see you all here tonight this evening to celebrate with us.
Utterly objective here. I am the editor of the FT Weekend, and we do like to think that we are the greatest weekend newspaper. And what I'm very confident in saying is that Joe's How to Spend It is the world's greatest luxury magazine. But nonetheless, you have to change, you have to adapt, you have to do new things. And that's what this evening is about. It's about a very, very exciting move into a new arena, into a new language. And it would be wrong to say that it was entirely straightforward. I had two very distinct memories of this process, and I need to put my glass on to see where James Lund is sitting. Over there, yes. So I remember about, I don't know, was it 2 years ago? I seem to recall it was a sunny afternoon, and I got this message pinged into my inbox from the FT's finance director. And if you are the editor of one of the titles, you get a message from the finance director, you think this could be one of two things. This could either be very problematic or this could be very exciting. And anyway, he said, let's talk now, let's talk this afternoon. So James turned up in my office with Axel, I think, who is also sitting there. And they said, look, we have this idea, we've been in touch with Elaph and so on, too many to mention, but obviously Othman and Emil, who we enjoyed having an early discussion with, on the phone. I would just like to salute the legal duo who I met downstairs, John Halton from the FT side and Alexander Ross from the Elaph side. I gather that it was a successful and harmonious coming together. Thank you for that. The FT's team, I mentioned James Lunt, but also Alex and Axel, huge thanks. I know there's been a lot going on behind the scenes.
Sure, editor. It's with colleagues like these that Jo delivers her truly remarkable magazine, which is now appearing ever more brilliantly online. So I'm going to hand over to Jo. There's just sort of one thing I'd like to say. How to Spend It has always been a success story, and the FT has always been very proud of it. But Jo has, in the 2 years you've been in charge, just taken it to a completely different level editorially. She's just changed the writing, the subject matter, the tone, kept it super classy, and I know that that is a key factor behind your wanting to have this partnership. So thank you for all of you for making this happen. I sense that this is an opportunity to grow into something even bigger. But I'd like to welcome Jo, the very brilliant editor of How to Spend It, just to talk about how to spend it.
So I'm Jo, I'm the editor of How to Spend It. The last time I actually dealt with any kind of Arabic translation of any magnitude was when I was 16 and I was doing my GCSEs in Dubai, where I lived for 4 years. So in a way, this has been an interesting homecoming to an alphabet I haven't looked up for a very, very long time, Jim, ha ha. But I remember being in Dubai at the time and seeing this place and on the kind of what was actually the cusp of like such tremendous social and kind of like economic change. And even at that point, we thought we thought the country was moving faster than lightning. And like in the subsequent years, it's totally transformed again. And I think the Gulf region has just become this incredible focal point of, you know, changing the narrative, refocusing how we all think about kind of the luxury market, rethinking about how we think about the consumer market. And also it's an incredible kind of destination for tourists. And we live in a far more international world now. So when we were first talking about doing this Arabic edition, we were really excited about the possibilities and also the idea of working together with a kind of different editorial team who would be producing original content, that we would be in a dialogue, and that it would be something that would broaden this the FT kind of remit even further onto the international stage, which is something which is always in our minds, especially as we kind of read more and more of our print and online, or our stories online. But I think it's also a testament to the fact that times have changed, that I'm in London, Sim was currently in Dubai, but she's been, I think, in about four different countries since we started doing this. Haber, who does the translations, is in Egypt. We've got other people who are at the print bases in Casablanca. I mean, this is a truly international project, and even throughout lockdown, and even though we haven't been able to leave our homes, we've managed to produce this like truly international publication. And long may it continue. I'm very excited about the future, and I'm really grateful for the opportunity to work with your team, who I've really enjoyed meeting and working with. Thank you.
So it's my pleasure to have you here, and I'm so honored to see this nice gathering, and for this kind of project, which I believe is going to be made different between other publication, which is a combination between two languages. I'm so proud about the team who done that work, from our friends from FT and How to Spend It, and from Elaph, Isaac, Nicholas, Summer. Unfortunately, she cannot make it. Next time, I'm going to issue her a driving license for tax to come here. Thank you.